Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. Today I've got a product review for you. It's a compact tripod from Camlink and it's the model TP-330. At the moment it's available on Amazon in the UK for just about £10 and that's $14 in the States. And I bought this so I can use it for some low level photography. A lot of my work tends to be ground level on plants and insects. And there's only my Modo tripod when I unscrew the column which will allow me to get down to within a few inches of the subject. So this seemed to fit the bill for me. It has a minimum height of 12 inches when you can collapse the legs. And the legs are tubular aluminium and the legs are held in place with the usual plastic cam lock systems. So in its minimum height position, that's just about 12 inches or 31 centimetres. It does have a pan and tilt head, and release the pan lock allows you to move the head in a panning position. There is a protractor scale marked in 5-degree increments, but it's rather difficult to see when you're above it because the camera obscures the view of the protractor. But nevertheless, the manufacturer has included a protractor scale, even though you may not be able to use it. And talking of other things that are a bit redundant, on the pan head itself is a bubble level. And the bubble level is affixed to the top plate, but only gives you control of the position of the head in a front to back motion. For me, it's more important to have the camera level with the horizon than it is to have the camera back perpendicular. Even if you swing this top plate into its portrait position, again it only ensures that the camera back is perpendicular to the subject. So again, it's a nice inclusion, but for me, misses the point. The tilt head itself is controlled with this handle, and the handle is plastic, but it has got a metal insert, and the inserts in the tilt head themselves are aluminium, so there shouldn't be any problem with wear into the plastic threads. The actual release plate itself is a quick release plate and has a locking system. It is the usual finger screw to tighten against the camera sole plate and has the usual locking pin for use with video recorders. Tends to get in the way with a still camera if you don't push it down before you attach it to the camera base. The actual quick release plate, although it looks to have a square section, actually will only fit in one of two positions, and that is with the locking pin either to the rear or the locking pin to the front of the tripod. Now, had the manufacturer thought about this quick release plate for a few more minutes, if we had the facility to rotate this quick release plate into any of the four positions, it would allow us to mount the camera in such a position that we could have used the horizontal bubble to ensure the camera was level for our horizontal shots, i.e. making sure that it's parallel with the horizon. But it didn't do that, so it's a missed opportunity. The actual quick release plate is held in by the usual dovetail type action and is quite secure in the fitting. The actual tripod itself will extend up to just short of 2 feet or 62 centimetres by extending the two section legs from within the body of the top section. They are complete with firm rubber pads, so they shouldn't scratch you at any tabletops. So that is the extended height up to about 62 centimetres, and you do get an additional 3 inches or 75 millimetres worth of travel on this geared centre column. If we mount a bridge camera on here, and here I'll mount the Panasonic FZ150 camera. With the camera mounted on its quick release plate on the tripod, it is quite securely held. The only problem I found with this tripod is that if I want to take a shot with the camera angled like this, then the force required to topple the tripod is reduced. Obviously the weight of the camera is now trying to pull over the center point of the tripod, and the actual force required to tip it is reduced somewhat. So in this case you want to ensure that the front leg is in the direction to prevent it from toppling. To overcome that toppling effect, then if we manufactured a plate which would allow us to move the centre of gravity to always keep it underneath the centre point of the tripod, that would reduce the toppling element substantially. The camera is provided with a small carry bag. It's the usual sort of waterproof nylon construction. The dimensions of this bag are probably about 2 millimetres bigger than the tripod, so it is a bit of a struggle to get the tripod into this bag, but nevertheless it is included with the tripod. It has a nice little strap, so you can either carry it over your shoulder or attach this to your camera bag so that you don't lose the tripod. I've had the tripod out on a couple of shoots now, and I will include some video and some stills that I've shot with this system. In general, I found it to be quite useful. If it actually went a few more centimetres towards the ground, it would be ideal for me. So I may look at either modifying this or finding some other method to get my shots lower to the ground. But it's ideal, it does fold down to a nice convenient size, it will fit in within my camera bag. It only weighs something like 600 grams, so it's not a great weight to carry around all day. Okay, that's the end of the review of the Camlink TP-330 compact tripod. Hope that was of interest to someone. And as usual, it's Graham saying thanks for watching, and I'll see you in later videos. Bye for now. Thank you.